continue on the front page of our bulletin. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. There is one hope and one spirit.
There is one hope and one spirit.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
Beloved, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, make us have perpetual love and reverence for your holy name, for you never fail to help and govern those whom you have set upon the sure foundation of your loving kindness. And we ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please sit for the readings.
The Old Testament reading is from Isaiah chapter 55. I was ready to be sought out by those who did not ask, to be found by those who did not seek me. I said, "Here I am, here I am," to a nation that did not call on my name. I held out my hands all day long to a rebellious people who walk in a way that is not good, following their own devices, a people who provoke me to my face continually, sacrificing in gardens and offering incense on bricks, who sit inside tombs and spend the night in secret places, who eat swine's flesh with broth of abominable things in their vessels, who say, "Keep to yourself, do not come near me, for I am too holy for you." These are a smoke in my nostrils, a fire that burns all day long. See, it is written before me, I will not keep silent, but I will pray, but I will repay. I will indeed repay into their laps their iniquities and their ancestors' iniquities together, says the Lord, because they offered incense on the mountains and reviled me in the hills. I will measure into their laps full payment for their actions. Thus says the Lord, as the wine is found in the cluster, and they say, "Do not destroy it, for there is a blessing in it," so I will do for my servants' sake and not destroy them all. I will bring forth descendants from Jacob and from Judah, inheritors of my mountains. My chosen shall inherit it, and my servants settle there. Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Thank you. despise nor abhor the poor in their poverty, neither does he hide his face from them. But when they cry to him, he hears them.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Now, before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore, the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. For in Christ Jesus, you are all children of God through faith. As many of you as were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is no longer Jew or Greek. There is no longer slave or free. There is no longer male or female, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus. And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's offspring, heirs according to the promise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to stand as you are comfortable, and we will sing In Christ There Is No East or West in our blue hymnals. 529.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus and his disciples arrived at the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. As Jesus stepped out on land, a man of the city who had demons met him. For a long time he had worn no clothes, and he did not live in a house but in the tombs. When he saw Jesus, he fell down before him and shouted at the top of his voice, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me." For Jesus had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. For many times it had seized him. He was kept under guard and bound with chains and shackles, but he would break the bonds and be driven by the demon into the wild. Then Jesus asked him, "What is your name?" He said, "Legion," for many demons had entered him. They begged him not to order them to go back into the abyss. Now there on the hillside, a large herd of swine was feeding, and the demons begged Jesus to let them enter these. So he gave permission. Then the demons came out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd rushed down the steep bank into the lake and was drowned. When the swineherds saw what had happened, they ran off and told it in the city and in the country. Then people came out to see what had happened, and when they came to Jesus, they found the man whom the demons had gone, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. Those who had seen it told them how the one who had been possessed by demons had been healed. Then all the people of the surrounding country of the Gerasenes asked Jesus to leave them, for they were seized with great fear. So he got into the boat and returned. The man from whom the demons had gone begged that he might be with him, but Jesus sent him away, saying, "Return to your home and declare how much God has done for you." So he went away, proclaiming throughout the city how much Jesus had done for him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
be with us. Be with us, Lord Jesus, as you were with your disciples, and make yourself known to us in the breaking of bread. Amen. Please do sit comfortably. I know some people were asking, "Gosh, you didn't have a mask on last week. This week you're wearing a mask. We're just still living in COVID land. I was with somebody last week who then tested positive. I've tested negative, but I don't want to be a vector and pass anything on that I might have to you." We're still living in this fraught landscape, aren't we? And then Paul writes this, and this is the revolution, this is the silent revolution. "There is no longer Greek or Jew. There is no longer slave or free. There is no longer male and female, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus." That's the vision of God, isn't it? That began right at the very beginning when all things were created. We were one in that singular moment. And we've been longing for that ever since. I don't know how many conversations I've had in the last, 2 years more about how polarized we are. And we all feel it. We all feel it in our bodies, we feel it in our relationships, we feel it every time we step out of the door. You know, everything is just a little bit more difficult, and I'm not just talking about COVID, although that's another layer. It's like this great onion of stress and anxiety, and it's hard to bear, it's hard to live with. And, you know, some of our leaders tell us to be afraid of each other. Don't be like them. Watch out for the others. But, you know, I can't help feeling that's a really old playbook, isn't it? Divide and rule. Divide and conquer. Because the truth is that working Americans, we have far more in common with each other, whatever our background, whatever our skin color, whatever our tradition or family story, we have much more in common with each other than we do with some of the elite who want to rule us. And there I've already divided us, and I apologize for that. But we are all children of God. We are all made in God's image. And yet we're all different, and that's part of the dilemma, isn't it? We're all God's children, and yet we are all so different. We have different backgrounds, we have different histories, we have different abilities and skills, we have different fears, we have different dreams and longings, and yet we are all one, made beautifully in the image of the divine. And I look around, I'm like, oh, so God doesn't just look like me, God looks like you. And God looks like you as well. And so that strange paradox, isn't it? Two things can be true at the same time. God is one, and yet God is also almost infinite diversity. We live in a world where we are all the more aware of the horror and the pain and the violence and the struggle and the heartache and, yes, the arguments and the polarization and all of it, all of the words, all of the noise, all of the images, they crowd in and fill our minds and our hearts. And sometimes, gosh, it's hard to hang on to hope, isn't it? It's hard to hang on to the vision of God or even see it. Lord, where are you? Where are you in the midst of all of this? And where is my place? And what is my part? Well, our place is in the heart of God. And our part is to follow in the way of Jesus. I was reminded this week that the very first followers of Jesus, before they were called Christians in the late first century, before that they were called the followers of the way. That's what Christians were called. Not reference to a person, but reference to a way of life, a way of being in the world, non-violent and loving, compassionate, giving, caring. And the path of nonviolence, when we're pushed with violence, either images or words or even actions, it is so hard not to push back in kind. And yet the path of nonviolence is the one that we're called to. In my actions, in my words, all of it. Paul said, dear friends, don't let the world confuse you. Because in Christ there is no Greek or Jew, there is no slave or free, there are not even men and women, but all truly are one. In the face, and I'm going to leave you with this, in the face of all that we have to cope with right now, I was having a conversation with one of my 18-year-old sons, and it was after one of the school shootings, and he just came to me almost in tears and said, Dad, what are we going to do? And I said, you know, I don't know fully, but if we're going to do and be anything, it has to be about love. And I think that's why what we do and what we celebrate inside this little community, this church, is all the more important. We're being shown why the path of love is really important. Because, yeah, the gloves are off, friends. This is not a dress rehearsal. This is life and death. And the vision of God is with us always. Amen. So would Maddie's parents, godparents, and family like to come forward and gather around the font? And everyone else, we are now on page 4 in our bulletins. Beautiful. Great, please. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. And then if you say, I present, will you be responsible for seeing the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life? Will you, by your prayers and witness, help Madison to grow into the full stature of Christ? And so, if you answer for Madison and for yourselves, do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord? And will all of you who witness these vows do all in your power to support Madison and her family in their life in Christ?
Yeah.
So, I invite you to stand as you feel comfortable, and let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ,
his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and seated on the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will.
So let us now pray for Madison, who is to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver her, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open her heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill her with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep her in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach her to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send her into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring her to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer. Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
The congregation, you're welcome to sit comfortably. If there are some children or young ones who would like to come forward so they can see, they're welcome. And we'll put the water into the font. This is our own beautiful Willamette River water. And this is special water brought from the River Jordan, where Jesus lived. Yeah. And now we're going to say a prayer over the water. Beloved, the Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your Son, Jesus, received the baptism of John. He was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the gift of baptism. In it, we are bound with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify, we pray you, this water by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory now and forever. Amen. Okay, you ready? Please. What name do you give this child?
Madison.
Madison Kaplan. I baptize you in the name of the Father, I know, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Bless you. I know. That's it. That's it. All good. Wasn't she brave? Wasn't she brave? Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon your servant the forgiveness of sin and raised her to the new life of grace. Sustain her, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give her an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, the spirit to know and love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Amen. Yes. Madison, Kathleen, you are sealed by Christ in holy baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Ben, can you and Daddy hold Madison's candle? Do you want to hold it? That's it. Receive this light. This is to show that you have passed from darkness to light. Shine as a light in the world to the glory of God, the Holy Trinity. So let us welcome Madison. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified. Proclaim his resurrection and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Amen. Congratulations. Bless you. Shall we stand to share the peace? Beloved, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Please do sit comfortably for a moment. I am so glad we were able to, that Maddie was able to be baptized today. We've already tried twice and it didn't quite work. That's life in COVID land. And a very special blessing to Maddie's godparents who are joining us online. It's wonderful to have you with us virtually. A couple of things to remind you of. Later on today, we will be having the funeral service and celebration of life for our beloved Susan Richardson. That's at 2:00 this afternoon, and you are welcome to join us for that. This week, we are joining with Grace Lutheran Church for Vacation Bible School. Well, we call it Summer Day Camp now. And there are little ones, pre-K and kindergartners, if there are some of those little ones in your life and you would like them to come, there are sign-up sheets, registrations at the back of church. It is not too late. A couple of other things. First of all, July the 3rd, that's July 4th weekend, we still have some tickets available for the baseball, for the night's baseball game. Beginning at 7:00 at the stadium on campus, and it's the night when they do all the fireworks. So if you would like to go, please see me afterwards or contact the church office. And lastly but not least, we are offering some coffee after the service outside in the courtyard if you would like to stay with us have a cup of coffee. You're welcome to do. Let us walk in love as Christ loves us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
When Israel
Shall we stand as we are able? Page 9 in our bulletins. May this Holy Eucharist be our hope in the world. The Lord be with you. thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, bring all things to completion in your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with Mary, your blessed mother, with Mary Magdalene, with Paul, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, O Almighty Father, now and forever. So we pray as Jesus taught us and prays with us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Please sit comfortably until Rosemary or Desiree invite you to come forward. Everyone is welcome to receive communion today. Please do let me know if you would prefer a gluten-free wafer as you come. I invite you to stand as you're comfortable. Page 14, we'll pray our final prayer together. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and the cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another, and you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. And so on this Father's Day, on this Juneteenth day, on this day of Madison's baptism, the blessing. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your heart and mind in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you and touch all whom you love and pray for this day and for all days. Amen. Our final hymn you'll find on the insert. And before we start, just a very big thank you to Peter, who was our cantor this morning. Bless you.